In previous videos on Scratch My Blocks, we've explored creating a custom block, tips and tricks for success, and when and why you might want to use them. The My Blocks category of blocks may be used to protect a sequence of code that has been proven to work, collect a sequence of code that will be used over and over, or to parse out sections of code for easier assembly elsewhere. But the blocks we've created so far performed the exact same steps each time. What if we want to perform the same sequence of code, execute the same procedure each time the custom block is called in the main program, but each time we want to make small changes, like the text shown, or the coordinate used, or adjust the value in one or more of these blocks? Let's learn how to create a MyBlock block that can be customized each time it is used. Let's start by setting up a custom block that has the character speak and say certain text at the same time. You'll see the code stack I want to use here. I'll click the Make a Block and give it a descriptive name as before, like speak and say. But since I want to customize the text my sprite will speak and say each time, I'm also going to add an input. With an input in place, the custom block will use the parameter, the data I provide in the input bubble, when I use the block. In this case, the input I'm choosing is number or text. And so I remember what the input is, I also want to give it a descriptive name, like what to say. Back in my scripts area, I'll add the desired code sequence under the define block. Then, in place of static unchanging text in the speak and say blocks, I want to use the input I created while creating my block. To get the input, click on the input label in the define block and drag it out to place it in a code block. In this case, I want to use the same text in both the speak and say blocks, so I'll do that two times. Now when I use this custom block in my main program, you can see the blank input bubble where I can enter the parameter, in this case, my custom text. Let's run the code to see how it looks.
Hi, I'm a dragon. I have hot breath.
I'm able to use the same code sequence and customize it over and over without rewriting this code stack each time. And if I need to make edits to the procedure, I only need to make changes under the define block to update everywhere the block is used in my main program.
Hi, I'm a dragon. I have hot breath.
Let's see another example where I want to customize the X and Y coordinate every time I run my custom block. As I create my custom block, I can add labels between inputs to help me remember what is what as I use the block and fill in the parameters. Or here is one more example where I'm using a custom block to help me set up a math game. In this case, I'm providing the two numbers in my question each time I use the custom block. The program is using those parameters in my custom block to ask the question, check the user's answer, and provide the appropriate response. I can even set up multiple custom blocks with or without inputs and use them together, or add a custom block inside another custom block. Be sure to check out the tips and tricks shared in the other My Blocks videos for more information. The possibilities are endless. What will you create?